All right, so in this video, we're going to be using Google Drive, and it's already full of files. So we'll be talking about the best ways to use those files, and we're going to be using them in your internet browser, and we're going to be using them when they're synced to your Windows desktop already. I've left-clicked on the gear icon, and I've gone to settings. Let's talk about a few settings that you should have the same way if you want to replicate what I'm doing. The one is, I don't have checked to convert uploads to Google Docs editor format. So that should say Docs, Sheets, and Slides. But what that means is if I take an Excel file and I upload it, Word or PowerPoint, it won't automatically convert it to the Google format. Because we're going to go over what to do with Microsoft Office files, there's some new capabilities there. And I also have this checked so I can edit Docs, Sheets, and Slides offline. I'm going to remain online when we're looking at this, but if you're not plugged in, I would suggest checking that and it will keep local copies for you. You can work on them and when you get back online, it'll sync them up. And those are the two settings that are important now. We'll click Done. And we're looking at the same files in Drive File Stream on the right and in Google Drive on the left. So if you want to work in a file that's not Sheets, Slides, or Docs, we'll come over into Drive File Stream. And it doesn't really matter right now that these are backed up. So you would work on them the same way that you would any other file. So if I wanted to open up this PNG file, let's say, if I double left click on it, like you typically would in Windows, it opens up with the default program that Windows thinks you want to use. And you just do whatever you want. Let's say I modify it a little bit. If I closed it and saved it, it would save this copy. And then the synchronized copy would get saved in Google Drive. So you can put any type of file that you want in Google Drive and you can work on it on your computer. It will still back it up, but you wouldn't necessarily do anything with it online. So if I found this PNG file here, it's just there to be backed up. I'm not going to edit in Google Drive. So the opposite is the case for the Drive, Sheets, and Slides. I would typically just edit those from here. Now you can come onto Windows and you can left click on it. And this will open up in Google Sheets. But that's not the typical workflow, at least that I use. If I'm going to be working on Sheets, Slides, or Docs, I'm just going to open them from Google Drive. I would left click here. So any file, even if it's synchronized in Google Drive, you can work on your computer and it will be synced in Google Drive. Now let's come into just Google Drive and talk more about how you can work with these files. So you can associate these files with different programs to open them. So as I talked about this PNG file, I would never do anything with this in Google Drive. But if I do open it in Drive, you can choose to open it with, and it will suggest some other programs. These are outside of Google Drive. So if you open these, you'd probably have to create an account and enter your credentials. And you may have to give that third-party application some access to your drive. I've done that with one program, so I will show you this type of file. And I've starred this file, so I know how to easily find it. Again, I don't know where this is saved, but I know that I starred it, so it's here. So this is a file from Coda, coda.io. But since I've given it permissions to Google Drive, when I left-click on it, it just opens in Coda. And I guess it's been a while because I had to give it permission again. Here we go. The file is saved in Drive, but it opens in Coda. Now, if I make my changes here, it's going to save the changes in Google Drive because the file is there, but all the interface and all the work that I do has nothing to do with Google. Google doesn't own Coda. It's just linked to Google Drive, and I use it inside of my browser, which in this case is Google Chrome. So that's the second way to work in files. The first is just on your computer. The second is through third-party applications. And the third is through what I would call the native apps. Let's just say I want to look at this example file of a function that you can use. And when I left clicked on it, it didn't have to ask for permissions. And this is a program that's run by Google. If you look at the address bar, docs.google.com/spreadsheets. So this is a native Google file, and it has some capabilities in it that your typical third-party application would not have. So we'll touch more on this in the next section of the course, as there's a lot of collaboration that you can do involving sharing the files and commenting back and forth. And there's another way to open a file that was recently introduced that's very important. So if you upload Microsoft Office files, so this would be Excel, PowerPoint, and Word, you can now open those in Sheets. So if I right-click and choose Open with Google Sheets, something very important is happening here. Because I opened it that way and I didn't change the settings to convert this file, this is being opened in the native Excel file format. It's not being converted to a docs. So if you wanted to download this again and keep it in Excel, you wouldn't lose any of the formatting. It's giving you a warning that not everything will work, but most of the things will. Another important thing to note is that you can also collaborate when you're working in Microsoft Office files in Google Drive. So the commenting features still work as long as you're inside of Drive. So I could come in here and I could left click and I could comment. Now it's giving you a warning if you edit this Excel file in Microsoft Excel on a computer, it could drop some of these comments. So there are some quirky things to keep in mind when you use Office files. So if you can, you're better off to use the native Sheets files, but there are lots of reasons to keep it in Excel if that's what you need to do, or Word or PowerPoint. So now you can do that in Google Drive. If I were to share this with a team member, there's all sorts of ways that you can interact within Google Drive, and we'll go over those features in this next video.